Hello everyone, today we have new video review, and as you can see, this time we are going to talk about fresh release from Edward. This is a limited edition kit in 1/48 scale. It's called the Kampfstift, and as you can see, it copies Dornier 17Z in 1/48 scale from 1939 to 1942. And once again, that's a limited edition, so straight away I will say it, if you would like to get one, hurry up, because they are quite limited and it's better to get them while you can. So we have a commercial sample here. It means you will get exactly the same stuff as what you'll see in this video review. We are going to open it together and check what is actually supplied in this kit. So first of all, box size is relatively big. Here you can see comparison with my hand. We have really beautiful box art here, and note that printing quality of this cover changed, so it's not as anymore the, I would say, matte surface as it was before. It's more on the gloss side, I would say even sateen. So you can see that it slightly glares on the bright white, but it's not as glossy as it could be. And also here on the side we have some information about the kit, but it's not written what is the main features. I guess they will be here. No, here we get all the markings which are included into this kit, so you can check them here. And we will check them later in assembly manual. But the main thing about this kit is that we have the... Oh, it's here. Sorry. So I will flip it like this. So we get the plastic for all Z subvariants of the Dornier 17Z. It's a plastic by ICM, obviously, and we reviewed it before, so you might be familiar with it. And we have P and masks from Edward. We also have bracing wheels and flotation devices for Z5 subvariants. And there is also decals sheet for 8 marking options, as you saw on the side of the box. We will talk about it later when we will be opening the decals and checking them closer. So let's open the box. It's a top opening box, a bit on the tight side, but still easy to open. And here's what we have inside. So quite unusual brown cardboard box, I would say, because usually Edward used the white cardboard. I guess it's aftermath of the recent fire, if you know. So packaging is standard for ICM plastic. We have all sprues in one plastic bag, and on the bottom we have all various bonuses. Well, I mean, there is plenty of space inside this box, and it's a resealable plastic bag, by the way. So just let me open it. So there is plenty of space inside the box. All parts should arrive to you intact, I hope. And nothing should be damaged, because there is plenty of space to fly around, let's say. And meanwhile, let me also remind you that you can support us financially. We have a special support DSV button on our website on the desktop version. So if you would like to help us with a small donation, do it via PayPal. We will be really glad for that, because it will help us get some new kits or maybe new photo and video equipment in order to improve our quality of the videos and photos. So here we start with the first plastic sprue. Let's zoom in a bit so that you will see more. And here we have engine gondolas, as you can see, this pair of parts. And also we have some parts for the landing gear here as well. Note the tail landing gear wheel is molded together with the fuselage part. But I guess we should zoom in so that you will understand better what I'm talking about. So we zoom in, and here you can check everything closer. So everything looks really nice. I don't have anything to complain about, and I think it will be easy to assemble these parts. You can also notice these large frames for the landing gear system. I think they will require some careful separation, but still attachment points are really thin, so I don't think it will be difficult to get them off the sprue. And here you can see more of the parts for the bomb rack and also fuel tank. Just give me a second, I'll check one part closer, because I do not see it on the plastic mat. So I guess it should be like this. And by the way, here you can take a look at this landing gear wheel, which is molded as a single piece part. So you have to be careful while painting it, or maybe get some mask set. I hope the current mask set, which is included here, it should feature the circle for this landing gear wheel, but we'll see. Next, I'm opening another plastic bag. Why? Because it is dedicated to... And next comes the clear plastic sprue, which is packed into the separate plastic bag. So here we have nice clear parts. It's a typical molding quality for ICM. I didn't have anything to complain about. And let's not forget that this is a limited edition from Edward, so we get masks out of the box. And in my opinion, it should be enough to get really nice paintwork on your aircraft. And so basically, you're literally covered out of the box. Next, we continue with another large plastic sprue. So this one is dedicated to Fuselage House, and here it is. So they are placed on both ends of this frame. Let's zoom out a bit. And now you can see here we have these two large parts. Here you can see comparison with my hand, they are really big. We also have one piece nose section, but as far as I remember, this type of the aircraft did not use such nose version, so there was a clear end. And now we can zoom in so that you can check everything in detail. So let's zoom in, and here you can take a closer look. So we have recessed panel lines, they are quite okay, they won't be lost under a layer of primer and paint. And here you can see also some interior parts which will be installed in the cockpit. So we have radio station, for example. There are also bulkheads and walls which will be providing necessary rigidity for this construction, because you saw that it is quite big even for 148 scale, so that's why it's necessary to have something inside. Here you can also see some tail parts, and if you flip it over, you can notice that these tail wings, they should be glued out of two halves. And for large fuselage parts, we have the guiding pins, so it will be easy to align them together, and you shouldn't be worried about any possible issues while assembling this large halves together. So why I'm a bit confused, I'm trying to understand what we will use from these two frames. So we will check them in a second. Let's remove this one off the table, and we will start with the next pair. Obviously, I'll show you only one because there is no need to show the same stuff again and again. So here, because it's a double, so here we get various engine and landing gear parts. You can see also one piece propeller. Landing gear wheels, they won't be used because, as you remember, Edward provides a resin replacement for that. And we can also zoom in as much as we can so that you can check all these parts in detail. So everything looks really nice. It's a typical ICM molding quality, so there is nothing to worry about. And that's really cool that you get engine out of the box. And that's not only one engine, you get both engines out of the box. This is really cool, and engine looks good, so it would be worth spending your time trying to paint and weather it in order to achieve a bit more realistic appearance. And believe me, even standard out-of-the-box version looks convincing in the finished state, so it won't be a bad idea to open the cowling on this model and show what is hidden inside. Okay. So next, we go on with last gray plastic sprue. This one is also quite big because it is dedicated to wings, and you can see that we have recessed panel lines. We also have separate ailerons here. Of course, we have engine gondolas separate, and I think here it's worth just zooming in into this section so that you can see external features. They look really good, and in my opinion, they're fine for 148 scale. And here you can see what we have on the opposite side. So we have guiding pins, and they will be necessary for such big parts, and they are here, so you won't be having any issues, I guess. Next, we continue with resin parts. So these ones are supplied in a separate plastic bag, which is a Ziploc bag, so just give me a second to open it and we will take a closer look. As you remember, there are several bonuses. It's interesting. So first of all, we get two main landing gear wheels. I'll show you this in a second. So here they are. Maybe camera will focus. Yeah, now you can see that we have really nice parts. They have weight effect, which is really crucial in this scale, and it will be visible. And we also have really nice features on the tire walls. So everything looks really cool in my opinion. But that's not all about landing gear wheels, because you remember, original plastic kit offers you the landing gear tail section as a one-piece part. Well, here we have it corrected because Edward decided to replicate it with these three parts. And in my opinion, that's really cool because it will help you to achieve a better looking result. As you can see, we have one part, this landing gear leg, casted out of white plastic. I think that's a 3D print, actually, maybe. Or maybe it is. It looks like a 3D print to me. And we also have flotation devices, so they were used on the Z5 version, if I'm not wrong. So here they are. And they were placed on the nose section in order to help pilots leave the aircraft if they landed on the water. Next, we continue with another special bonus for this limited edition. So we have this plastic bag with two PE frets. So just give me a second to open it. And as you noticed, there is one pre-painted and one sprue finished in a natural golden color. Both will be used in order to achieve a better features and better looking aircraft in such big scale. So we are going to start with this pre-painted PE fret, and you can notice that we have some parts for the cockpit, seat belts obviously, also a lot of parts which will be actually replacing the original plastic parts, I suppose. As you can see, a lot of bending to do as well. But that's not all, because we have also the golden PE fret here. So this one will be used not only for internal features, but also for external. I guess maybe the engines will also get something, so that's really cool. And of course, it will make your model a bit superior to the original ICM offering, which did not feature the PE parts. Next, I'm opening another plastic bag. So here we have mask sheet. Just give me a second to get it out of the plastic bag. And we will take a closer look. Of course, these are pre-cut masks. So here we have canopy masks and also masks for landing gear parts. And you can notice that they will be handy for these elements because they will let you cover these large parts without any unnecessary issues and wasting your time. Next, we continue with a big plastic bag which is dedicated to decal sheets. So just give me a second, I'll open it as well. And we will take a closer look together. So what do we have here? I need to remove it first, and we will take a closer look together. First, I would like to show you the small decal sheet. So it is dedicated to stencils. Of course, it is printed in Edward. Maybe I'll close the camera a bit so that it will be just slightly darker image. We also have decals for instrument panels, so in case you are not a fan of PE parts, you can use these decals and you will be good to go. And of course, it's really cool that you have stencils in 1/48 scale. Next, we continue with, let's say, with the main decal sheet, which is dedicated to all necessary symbols for several marking options. Here we have a segmentation, which is a really useful feature in such large sets. And you can notice that printing quality is really nice, and swastika is supplied in this state and also in separated state. So basically, even if this section will be cut off on your market, still you will be getting these symbols, which are easy to assemble into one. And next, we continue with assembly manual. So this one is printed in form of large color printed brochure. We have the same image on the cover, just like on the box art. And let's open it. So here we have a parts map. Of course, blue color means that these parts won't be used, and assembly process starts with an cockpit parts, and note how many parts made out of PE you have to use straight away. So a lot of tiny elements, so be ready to work with tweezers, with sharp tweezers preferably, because otherwise it will be a nightmare. And here we continue with more parts for the cockpit. Even seat belts here get installed on the pilot seat. Next, we continue with more parts getting installed into the fuselage half. Next, we have some assembly options, and as you can see, it will depend on the version you choose, I guess. So we're still working on the fuselage halves here, and here you can see that only on the step 19, I guess, because this one is 18. So we joined them together, and you shouldn't forget about these bulkheads. As I say, they will provide extra rigidness for this construction, because otherwise it will be a bit wobbly due to its large size. Here we have fuel tank, which will be also placed in the fuselage, and we also assemble the wing halves together. Do not forget to paint these areas for the landing gear wheel wells. We install separate ailerons and then join wing together with the fuselage half. And here we start working on the tail section. So all tail surfaces will be assembled out of two halves, as you remember. We also assemble bomb racks, which will be installed in the fuselage. And here manufacturer shows that we continue with engine gondolas. So as you can see, you will have to assemble them out of separate panels. And of course, landing gear, we use the resin wheels which are supplied in this kit. We start working on the engine, and here it is quite interesting to see whether there will be any PE parts used for this area. And from what I see, there are none of them used for the engines, which is really surprising, because I was expecting at least some ignition wires replicated with PE parts, but they're not here. I guess it's because they will be closed behind these covers. So the engines, as I said before, they will be visible only if you decide to open the cowlink on your model. And note that manufacturers still preserve this version, so you can open the cowlink on your model. So definitely consider such possibility. Next, we continue with flotation devices in case you would like to replicate Z5 version. It's marking D. And here we continue with more of the fuselage panels and some machine guns. We install clear parts, and of course we have mask guide. So mask guide is provided not only for the canopy but also for landing gear wheels. And here we have more masks, because as you remember, the nose section is clear in this aircraft. So first marking option here comes from Germany in 1939. By the way, they will release some interesting stories in Edward Info, so definitely read it, because there is some useful and interesting information about this aircraft. So next we continue with aircraft from Belgium, August 1940. Next is France, September 1940. And it has this interesting red line on the tail and wing fin. And next is aircraft from France, October 1940. This one is from Greece, 1941. Here we have winter camouflage. I guess, yes, it was operating in Soviet Union in 1941. It's easy to guess because of these yellow stripes, as we all remember. Here we have, of course, aircraft from Africa. And one more is from Finland, so it's February 1942. And by the way, some aircraft in Finland operated till 1950s, which is really interesting. So again, you learn more about this in Edward Info. And next we have stenciling guide, and that's pretty much all. So all in all, we get really interesting limited edition, where we get a lot of handy accessories which will help you to get a bit more sophisticated Dornier in 1/48 scale. Of course, I will be happy to hear your opinion about such release. Write it here in the comment section below. If you like this video, do not forget to press the like button, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and I will see you in the next video review as usual. Thank you for joining me today, and bye.